Dear students, see in the last time in lesson number 9, that is force and laws of motion. See, we have completed theory part. We took some example also. See, now today we will complete the remaining examples and start with the exercise numericals. Now see, next is exercise sum number 9. Example number 9.8. Now you can see in the textbook in the diagram, say two hockey players. This is first player, mass m1, moving with the velocity v1. Now let us say our ball, mass is m2. See, the moving in opposite direction, okay, with the velocity of 6 m/s. See, m1 is 60 kg. And velocity is 5 m/s. Okay, m1 is 60 kg. Now this is m2. Mass is 55 kg. Velocity is 6 m/s. Okay, now they come near to each other, okay, and finally they move in the same direction. See, we have to find out the final velocity of the system. Now see, as a convention, see, this velocity, if I take positive, the velocity in the opposite direction we should take negative, okay. So here, to find out the final velocity of the ball, we have to use law of conservation of linear momentum. Now what do the law of conservation of linear momentum says? See, the initial momentum of the system and the final momentum of the system remain constant. Now see, initial momentum our system is made of two mass m1 and m2, so it will be p1 is m1 v1. Here m1 is 60, v1 is 5, m2 is 55. See, v2 we have to take negative. Why? Because it is moving in opposite direction. So this will be 300 minus 30. Okay, so this is the initial momentum of the system. Okay, now see, once they collide, they move in the same direction. After collision, system move in same direction. Now here v1 and v2 are in opposite direction, that's why v2 we have taken negative. Now see, the final momentum of the system is made up of two parts, is made up of, okay, now we have to find out the final velocity of the ball. Let us say, like, final velocity is v dash, so it will be v2 m1 plus m2 into v dash. Okay, what is m1 here? 60. What is m2? 55. Okay, now by law of conservation of linear momentum, okay, by law of conservation of linear momentum, p2 is equal to p1. Okay, now p2 is minus 30, so v dash is minus 30 upon 115. See, that you can solve is minus 0.26 m/s. Okay, so this is how we can find out the final velocity of the system. See, initially both were in the moving in opposite direction, so p1 and initial m1 momentum is momentum of first particle, we have taken positive, object and second is negative. Okay, then final momentum, they move in the both directions, so they have a, let us say, common velocity. That we have taken v dash, so that will be p2, and by law of conservation of linear momentum, p2 is equal to p1. So by using this, we have obtained the value of the final velocity of the board. Now this brings to completion of the our example part. Now we start with the exercise numerical. Now see, whatever the theory part, theory based question, that we'll do, we'll discuss better in the classroom. Okay, right now we take the numericals in which calculation part is there. Okay, so we start with the exercise numericals now. Now, see, the first one is exercise number 9.7. Okay, from a rifle of mass 4 kg, okay, let us say mass 4 kg rifle, okay, bullet of mass M2, that is 50 gram. Is fired. Okay, calculate the initial recoil. Okay, calculate the initial recoil. Okay, now see, the velocity of the bullet is 35 meter per second. Okay, now we have to calculate the initial recoil. So for that we use law of conservation of linear momentum. Okay, law of conservation of linear momentum. Now here, initial recoil means velocity of rifle, that is not given. Okay, or we can say, okay, no problem, V1 also we can take. Now initially system is at rest. Okay, why? When the bullet is not fired, see, the system is red, so initial momentum is zero. Okay, when bullet is fired, okay, final momentum okay, now mass M1, velocity V1, M1 V1 plus M2 V. Okay, now by law of conservation of linear momentum, V2 is P1, so M1 is 4, V1 we have to find out. Okay, 50, 35. Okay, and P1 is the initial momentum, that is zero. Okay, so what we have used, law of conservation of linear momentum, final momentum should be equal to initial momentum. So we can find out V1 is, so this will make 0.005 into 35 upon 4. Okay, so you can solve this as minus 0.43 meter per second. Okay, see, the recoil velocity should be less as possible. See, here we can see that it is 0.43 meter. Okay, that is 40 centimeter only. Why? Suppose a soldier fires like this and if recoil is very large, see, he can be injured. That's why it is designed that the recoil velocity become as less as possible. Okay, so this is nothing but our exercise number 9.7. okay, now next is exercise sum number 9.8. Okay, now see exercise number 9.8. Two object of mass m1 100 gram, m2 is 200 gram. Okay, are moving along the same direction with the velocity of 2 meter per second and 1 meter per second. Okay, now naturally they are moving in the same direction, okay, on the same line. Naturally we see here V1 is larger than V2. So, okay, they collide, okay, they collide, that is collision. Okay, see after collision, the first object, that is V1 dash, okay, find out the velocity of the second object. Okay, now here also we have to use law of conservation of linear momentum. Now initial momentum, m1 v1, see 100 gram is 0.1 kg, 200 gram is 0.2 kg, 0.2, 0.1 into 2, 0.2 into 1. Okay, this is initial momentum. Now m1 again is 0.1, m2 is 0.2. Okay, see we have to find out the final velocity. Okay, we have to find out the final velocity. Okay, final momentum m1 v1 dash plus, okay, m1 is how much? 0.1, v1 dash is 1.67, m2 is 0.2 and v1 dash. Okay, now we have substituted the value. See the initial momentum we have obtained is 0.3. So by law of conservation of linear momentum, okay, V2 is P1. Now this is point, we can write as 0.167 plus 0.2 into this. Okay. Is equal to 0.3. So V2 dash okay. Now this is we have to solve. Okay, you can okay, so final answer you get for 1.165. Okay, this is how we can solve. So here, see we have used the law of conservation of linear momentum. See, this is our exercise number 9.8. Now, see exercise number 9.13. Now see a truck, start from the rest So initial velocity is zero. Roll down a hill with a constant acceleration. Okay. Distance covered is 400 meter and time is 20 seconds. Okay. What is the force acting on it? Now, see, we have to find out the force. Which equation will use? See, Newton's second law of motion gives the magnitude of the force. So we have to use F is equal to ma. Now, see, the distance covered is given, time is given, initial velocity is given. We have to find out A. Now recall our equation that we have discussed. V is equal to u plus at, d is equal to ut plus half at square, d is equal to v square minus u square upon 2. See here, d is given, u is given, t is given, a we have to find out. So naturally our selection will be second equation, d is equal to ut plus half at square. Now distance is 200, start from rest, u is 0, a time is 20. So 200, 400 upon 2 will be 200 a. Okay, so what we get acceleration as distance covered, sorry, here it is given as 400 meters. Okay, so acceleration we obtain okay. Now see our equation F is equal to ma, that gives us the magnitude of the force, that is mass of the truck is 7 ton. Okay, mass. Now see, ton is a commercial word. Okay, 1 ton is 1000 kg. Okay, so mass is 1000, 7000. Okay, and acceleration is 2. Force is 14,000 meter. Okay, so this is how we can calculate the force acting. Now, see, next is exercise number 9.14. Okay, now stone of 1 kg. Is thrown with a velocity of 20 meter per second across the frozen surface of a lake. Okay. Now let us say frozen surface, a stone is thrown like this. Okay. And comes to rest after traveling a distance of 50 meter. Let us say it covers distance of now the frozen lake. Okay, now comes to rest. Final velocity is 0, distance covered is 50 meter. Okay, what is the force acting? Now, see, F is equal to ma is known to us. See, we have to find out the acceleration. Okay, we have to find out acceleration. For that, we require A. So, our equation A is equal to v square minus u square upon d. V is 0. Why? Because the stone will stop here. U is 20, distance covered is 50 meter, minus 400 upon 100. Now, here the velocity decreased, that's why we have got retardation, there is a negative acceleration. Now see, the force acting is F is equal to ma, mass is 1 kg, acceleration is minus 4. Okay, see, remember, we should remember to write the unit also. So this is how we obtain force F is equal to ma. Okay, this is a retarding force. Okay. Now see, next is example number 9.15. okay, xi is some number, 9.15. Okay, see, an engine of, let us consider a train here. Let us say this is engine. See, wagons are like this, or coach. Okay, engine of mass is 8,000 kg. Okay, now 5 wagons of (clears throat) 2,000 kg. Okay, 10,000. Okay, that is a mass. Engine exert a force of 40,000 newton. Now see the force. Okay, but see there is a friction force also. Okay, the friction force later on we'll study always in the opposite direction of the motion. Friction force of 5,000 newton. See, what we see here in this example, there are two forces which are in opposite direction. So what is net force? Let us say this is F1 and this is F2. Net force. Okay, now the total mass. Is M1 plus M2. See, M1 we have considered mass of the engine, that is 8,000 kg, and there are 5 wagon of 2,000 kg mass. So wagon mass will be 2,000 by 5, 10,000. So total mass will be 8,000 . Okay, so we have to find out the acceleration. Okay, now okay, so what is the net accelerating force? Net accelerating force we have obtained, yes. Okay, now the acceleration of the train. Okay, acceleration of the train, we are asked to find out the acceleration of train. So there is a second part of the question. First part is a net accelerating force. Now remember here we have been asked acceleration of train only. So the mass rate 8,000 kg only. Okay. Now 5,000 wagon of each 2,000 force. So total acceleration A is F upon M1 plus M2. M1 is F1, we have obtained 13,000, 8,000 plus 10,000. Yeah, so this is how we have to find out. Now, force of wagon on 1 and 2. Now, this acceleration we obtain as, yeah, we should have a calculator. See, this will be 1.94 meter per second square. Okay, now third part, force of wagon on 1 and 2, force of wagon on, force of wagon 1 on wagon 2. Okay, what is the mass? See, there are five wagons. Okay, there are five wagons. So after the wagon one, how many wagon are there? Four wagon. So what is the total mass of these four wagon? Third part we have been asked to, force of wagon. So as I told, after wagon one there are four wagon, each of 2000 kg mass, so that will be four wagon will be mass is 8000. See, the acceleration of the system is 1.94, so we can calculate. Okay, that is 15,520. Okay, so here also we use the formula F is equal to ma. Okay, so this is an interesting sum. See, the total mass of the engine and wagon will be 2000 into 5, 10,000 plus engine mass is 8,000. So 10,000 plus 8, 18,000. See the force, see the pull of the engine is 40,000 Newton. See, the friction force is always in the opposite direction motion. So the net force will be 40,000 minus 5,000 will be 35,000. See, the total acceleration of the system will be force upon total mass. Now force of wagon 1 on 2 will be, see, after wagon 1 there will be 4 wagon. So that will be mass total is 8,000. Acceleration is 1.94 we have calculated. So this is how we can obtain the force of wagon 1 on wagon 2. So this is about the exercise number 9.50. Now next is exercise number 9.60. Okay, now see, automobile vehicle has a mass of 1500 kg. Okay, what is the force between the vehicle and the road if the vehicle is to be stopped with a negative acceleration of 1.7? Okay, now see the acceleration, negative acceleration. Why? Because see, we have to stop the vehicle, we have to apply the force in opposite direction, that will produce retardation. Retardation is nothing but negative acceleration. So here acceleration is 1.7, but because it is retardation, we take a negative sign. So our formula F is equal to ma, 1500 into minus 1.7. Okay, 1500 into, okay, that will give us, see, the negative sign shows it is a retardation. Okay, negative sign shows it is a retardation. Now see, this is about exercise number 9.16. See, mass is given. See, the acceleration also is given. So by using the formula F is equal to ma, see, we can calculate. Now see, next is exercise number 9.90. As I told, see, we are taking only the calculating part. Okay, see, the theory part question we'll discuss in the classroom itself. Now exercise under, now see here, there are two object, mass 1.5 kg m1 here, m2 also of the same mass, but they move in the opposite direction. Okay, on a same line. Okay, now let us say this is the same line. See, the velocity of both is 2.5 meter per second. But as a convention, if the right hand side velocity, if I take positive, opposite direction velocity we should take negative. Now the question says, after collision they move in the same direction. आफ्टर कोलिजन, आफ्टर कोलिजन लेट अस से मूव इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, व्हाट इज द फाइनल वेलोसिटी, ओके, व्हाट इज द फाइनल. नाउ हियर आल्सो वी हैव टू यूज लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम. नाउ व्हाट इज इनिशियल मोमेंटम, m1 v1, see mass is 1.5, see the this velocity we take in the opposite direction, so both are the same term in one with the negative sign, initial momentum is zero. Now final momentum p2, the equation says they both move together, so see the velocity after collision. Okay, now that will be 1.5 plus. Okay, now see we have got MP1 initial momentum, then this is a final momentum. See by law of conservation of momentum, by using law of conservation of momentum, p2 is p1, that is 3v dash is 0. Okay, so the final velocity of the system will be 0. So here also we have used the law of conservation of linear momentum. Now today we have taken some exercise numericals. Okay, next time we'll take remaining exercise numericals and we'll have some more practice of the numericals. Okay, thank you.